if you were a kid in the early 70s, it was probably one of your favorite shows. It was The Partridge Family. And as you remember, the singing clan toured the country performing their many hit songs.
Leading the family was Mom Shirley Jones, but perhaps the person most responsible for the show's success was the singing teen, the heartthrob David Cassidy. And he joins us this morning as our special It's Your Call guest. We can now relive all the memories on Nickelodeon, right? David, good to have you with us.
See him on Nickelodeon.
Thank you. Yeah, it's nice to be here this morning. Yes, indeed. In fact, on July the 12th, Nick at Night is going to premiere The Partridge Family 5 nights a week, every weeknight at 8 o'clock. And yesterday I saw the bus for the first time. They reconstructed
the original bus?
No, they took a replica. It's I could have lied to you and told you it was the original bus. You wouldn't have known the difference.
Probably
it looks
not.
Exactly like it, except it's much cooler inside. They've got all this great 70s motif, and they put air conditioning in it. And there's video cameras in the back. It's great. So we did to kick this thing off in Chicago yesterday. Danny Bonaducci is on the loop there in Chicago.
Great radio station.
And he's doing really well. So we did a photo session for People Magazine on Saturday, apparently, where they tell us we're going on the cover of People Magazine. So there's a tremendous enthusiasm for it coming back. I think for all of the obvious reasons, the show was really successful in its time, and I think it's been away a long time. But I think that the 80s and the 90s have been a lot about seriousness and ultra-violence and the plague of AIDS, and I think in a way people are longing to go back to that mindless decade when we had a lot of fun. You know,
watch you worry about your hair on every episode.
Yeah, I don't have to worry about it anymore. I just cut it now, you know. Yeah, well, for me that was the fun part, is that the character got to evolve. That in the beginning there was no comedy at all. I was just this guy who fixed the bus and sang lead and played.
Right.
He had no character really, and we started to find, because the chemistry really worked between Danny and Susan and I, that Susan played real straight, that Danny and I could be the balance to that. I guess much like Mary Tyler Moore, or even like in Seinfeld now, where he plays straight and the other guys are all off the wall. But it worked. Well,
it's good that the producers saw that at the time that it happened and recognized that it was something that they should continue.
Well,
we got a ton of calls for you that we've got
to
get to. Wendy is our first caller this morning. Wendy, calm down and go ahead. You're on the air now.
Hi, Wendy.
Cassidy.
Hi. I'd like to know where you call your home nowadays.
I got a little suitcase that I keep it. I actually call Los Angeles home, but in fact, thank you for asking this question. I'm moving to New York because I'm going to be starring in a show called Blood Brothers on Broadway as of August the 2nd. So please come and see me. It's a real departure from the Partridge Family. It's a very powerful, it's a wonderful piece of theater. It's been a big hit in the West End of London. And they brought the original cast over from London to play the first 3 months. And it was nominated for Tony for Best Musical, and two leads in it were also nominated. So please, if you're coming to New York, come and see it. I'll be there to the end of the year.
Our next call this morning is Becky. Go ahead with your question this morning, Becky.
Hi, David.
Hi, Becky.
Well, I just wanted to call and tell you that thanks to you, I had a kidney transplant years ago. And
I've done that to a lot of people, you know. Bang. Here he comes. Kidney's gone. What happened?
No, well, it just set up a disease that deteriorated it, and we had to go in for a replacement, but my mom had put your picture everywhere. And it really helped.
Oh.
And, I know it sounds corny and everything.
No, it doesn't. You know, thank you for that.
I wasn't supposed to be able to have children, and now I'm on my second. He's
fantastic.
Have you named one?
Congratulations.
Name one David yet?
Thanks. Pardon?
Did you name one David?
Eric David.
Eric David.
Well, my husband thinks it's after him.
And now
so much for that secret.
I want you to know I'm really flattered, and I'm pleased that, you know, everything worked out for you. And if I was able to bring a little light into your life, you just gave it back to me, and I thank you for that.
Okay.
So, all the luck in the world, and carry on. I hope you have a ton more.
Oh, he's due any day now, so we're all excited.
Great.
Our next caller this morning is really from Columbus, Ohio, although I guess she's in the metro area and she follows you around all the time.
Really?
Nancy.
Hi.
Nancy, go ahead.
Hi, David. How are you?
Hi. Well, how are you, Nancy?
I'm awake here in Detroit.
Yeah, and were you at the thing yesterday in Chicago?
Yeah, I caught you
on
the loop.
Sure.
There there at the cafe.
At the Loop and at the cafe.
Chicago, yeah. The Loop in Chicago.
The Loop in Chicago, that's right. We won't keep saying that. I promise I'm not going to keep driving that home. But we did a major event. There were hundreds of people at the Hard Rock Cafe to see the Partridge Family bus. And, in fact, Danny Bonaducci and I get off of it. And it was pretty weird for me, as you can probably imagine. It's been a long time. I was able to distance myself from that show. I walked away from that experience. The last concert tour I did, I was playing to like 40 and 50,000 people. And as much as I loved doing the show creatively, it left a lot for me to be desired. I was, in fact, a serious actor before I started doing
it. What's it like to look back on that series now, some almost 20 years later?
It's great for me because I have been able to distance myself, and I have a successful career now as both as a songwriter and a musician and doing concerts and stuff and as an actor. And I think that, you know, a couple of years ago I became a parent myself, and I like the idea of my kid growing up and knowing why all these people are coming up to me and talking to me about Keith or about the Partridge Family. I think it's a good, also it sets a very positive, even though it's very simple and it's not real deep, the messages were very positive, the role models were very positive, witnessed by a couple of the callers, and I think that it can't be a bad thing. It was great for people's imaginations. They all felt like, well, if I get a friend of mine or my brother and my sister and someone in the show, you know, I could be an actor, I could be that guy. And it's the sense of the political aspect of the movement of the 60s, of the social revolution of the 60s, was gone, but still there was a sense of, in the 70s, of freedom being the key, you know, and the Partridge Family represented that, like a family could play together, live together, you know, have fights together, fall apart, and yet still there was glue there, and yet we got to go on the bus, and we get to go through America, like, isn't it unbelievable?
And,
yeah, I mean, it's a cool idea.
It is.
It is, you know. I understand. I saw it for the first time in 15 years the other day, and I really was impressed. I thought the show was really good. I understood now why it was successful, you know, and it really plays well. So I think it's going to be a big hit for Nickelodeon.
We got some more of your fans on the line.
We have Bob on the line right now. Go ahead with your question, Bob.
Hi, David. How are you?
Good, Bob. How you doing?
Good. I had one question. You know, being a part of the Partridge Family, you know, as popular as it was,
yeah,
when it ended, did it help or sometimes hinder you in future parts?
Oh, it's no question it was a big obstacle for me to get over. I mean, there's no question also it was a double-edged sword for me, Bob, because the thing is, it made me a very, very successful guy, but I was going down this path of being a really credible, hot actor. I came from the theater, I came from New York, George Abbott, the legendary director, cast me in a Broadway show. I did probably 10 guest leads in dramatic television shows at the time, and I was getting offers to do movies, and I was like right around it. It happened for me very quickly, and I moved out. I was 19 years old, and I was trying to pay my rent, so really and truly what I was most hopeful about was being able to carry on for the next year or two. I had no idea what would happen to me, you know, with David Cassidy comic books and dolls and dresses and guitars and bubblegum cards and all that stuff. And I was totally unprepared for that hysteria and the mania that accompanied me everywhere. And my life changed so dramatically, as did my career. And I couldn't get people to see me as anything more than Keith, which, as I've said on a couple of occasions, you know, I tried to convince people that I had more depth than Beaver Cleaver, and it was tough, you know.
Well, obviously that's proven to be the case. So you've overcome the obstacles,
yeah,
and you're here now with a new show opening on Broadway in August, and we're glad that you could take a few moments out to visit with us today here on It's Your Call.
And you're going to be at the Metro Music Cafe in Royal Oak.
Thank you for pointing that out, Jill.
At noon today.
I'd love to invite some of these people to come down and join us for lunch, because we're going to
see the bus
is going to be there. They're playing. The great thing, they have the bus hooked up with these speakers outside, and they're playing all the old Partridge Family hits, which is really pretty cool. So it's
fun. Thanks for coming by this morning.
Yeah. Okay.
Good to meet you.
Thank you.
Good to see you, David Cassidy.
And guess who's standing by?
Is
one of his biggest fans.
No, I don't know. I don't see her stand. She went into a swoon a moment ago. We're reviving her now.
I need to see her
right after this.
TV2.
Let's take one more look at the weather. We have some sunshine out there starting out the day on a pretty nice note. Temperatures are on the mild side, 76 degrees, with a southwest wind at 7. We have a special guest.
Talk about that wind.
I can.
Hi. Great.
Let's talk about the wind, shall we?
All right, here it is.
Stand
here.
Stand right
point
over
to
here.
It. So you have to kind of...
You know, this is tough doing this.
See, it's not as easy as it looks.
There's a southwest wind at 7. It's 90% humidity.
Mm-hmm.
And the barometer is 29.9.
That's very good. That's good. Yeah.
As is my heart going like this, Ken. So anyway, here we are in Detroit. It's great to be here.
I'm going
to
kill you, Jerry and Jill.
Terrible, aren't they? You know, did I ever tell you I was a big fan of yours, too?
No, you didn't tell me that.
So good night now.
Okay, thanks for stopping by, Dave. Tough act to follow. Let's take a look at the rest of the weather.